Hello everyone, I am Vineet and this is Raghu. We are part of the Interactive Grading Application Group. But the process of conversion of raw marks to letter grades is really not an easy process. Even though it can be done by formula-based approaches, there is still a need for manual intervention to assure that grades are assigned fairly to the students. So we came up with a solution to this problem by making an interactive tool where the user gets to enter the marks data, and we have an interactive plot that plots the frequency distribution of the grades assigned to students, and it also gives the grade boundaries, fixed grade boundaries. Now the user has the capacity to move the grade boundaries dynamically according to his preference so that he can ensure that grades are assigned fairly, and the statistics of the grades are also updated live on this tab. Hello. Raghu will demonstrate a few additional features.
I'll now just say why we need to make an interactive graph of the frequency distribution of students. Let's say here we have a plot. Here you can see the B's, it is, I'll better explain it on the board. Let's say this is the B grade. So the frequency distribution might be like this. So what you can see is from here the A starts. So if you observe, these people from half of this plot are capable, which they could be considered as A, and the other people, they are far behind these people. We are grouping them as they have the same capacity. So this is not the alone application, and we also have implemented different algorithms of IITB, and also we gave some custom algorithms. So every year when every professor has marks, so he has to.
No problem with that particular curve.
That was one example.
On the right hand side or the left hand side.
Yeah.
Yes,
what sir?
What do you explain as the problem?
We are in B grade, we are having different people. So they could not be all be of same capacity.
Yeah, but that is going to happen anyway. How are you going to solve that problem?
No sir, in relative grading system, our requirement was told is we have to in this way we can identify the troughs easily by the
identify the troughs.
The crest and trough we can identify easily. And if you do it in Excel, you don't know where these things happen. So you have to test all the data and.
I didn't need to identify it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it was one of the application of this thing. We also implemented this thing. IITB is following this. We are said that it is following this thing. They'll provide some A grade and.
IITB following something.
No.
So grading schemes.
Grading scheme. This is a grading scheme.
IITB,
relative grading scheme it
IITB is. IITB does not follow any grading scheme. Okay. No, the grading scheme is completely dependent on the professor.
Yes, sir. So,
So IITB has no grading scheme.
Okay. No,
there is a guideline.
Yeah, those guidelines.
Guideline is 15%, 15% of the top is AA or something like that.
Yeah,
ABB, I don't know with the AB business what it is.
Yeah.
At my time, it was 15% AA.
Hmm.
I think the bottom 5 or 10% is a failure.
Hmm.
In between, there are some percentages.
Oh, we worked under Professor Bhattat.
But that
professor.
Is not mandatory. That is not binding on anybody.
Yeah. So that's what we implement those guidelines which they provided as an algorithm.
Yeah.
Now the teacher or the user who makes use of this, he can like try and place those draggable bars at those troughs. So that, go to that tab. For example, here, AB is being assigned to these people, but there are a lot of members who got AB here. So you can, like, if the professor is lenient, he can drag this bar to here and include these people also under the A grade. Like, if it's close by, like, if there are many people at 81, then they can't lose out a grade just because they got one mark less. So you can just drag this there and include them under the higher grade.
You can still do this in Excel, But every year you just get a lot of data of students. If you, let's say we have 500 students and we got all the data, and we can still have an equation in Excel and substitute all these things. What if you wanted to know what will be the new statistics if we move the boundaries to new values?
We could Excel, I can do this.
Yeah, no, you can do this. We don't
say track bus and you can interactively.
Correct.
You should try every value for every time you have to change every grade, and you have to paste all the data and do it.
Fine, you go ahead. You allowed him to drag bars. I know why. Your explanation was completely wrong. That's why I intervened.
Okay, fine.
Okay. You have to draw a bar at a trough.
Yeah.
That is the recommendation. That is not what you said.
No.
Okay.
Not
you said this and this, there's so many marks difference. That is bound to happen anyway.
Yeah.
Okay.
The trough is the main part. So we have many options. We have four grading schemes. Both of them are follow IITB guidelines, and we also have custom grading scheme where the faculty himself can enter the grade bounds. Now in the second module,
if we are using some different scheme,
if I'm allowed to change that bar, why I will do it like this?
The initial grades usually.
Why? I will start with all zero and start moving bars. No.
No, like
the custom is not known.
Anyway,
it doesn't matter.
Okay.
You are doing that. Next, what they have done.
So, the second.
And we also wrote it like a class. We wrote it in object oriented. So, if you wanted to include your university's grading scheme, you can just add it to the method. Even we are basically using charges to plot this graph. If you just wanted to plot the graph, it is very easy to use charges, but these interactive things, we have to study the how charges is working, because we need to position these bars which was not there in charges. We wrote everything for it, and plotting is only 50 lines of code, I think. And because the scale changes automatically, because if we have more data, like the exam is for 160 marks or something, the scale will be independent of the, it will be depending on the marks. So we have to study how the framework works, and then we have to do it, and we can show dynamically what the initial grade statistics and the new grade statistics. This was not a new idea, this was a solution for already existing. We are assembling all the things. It was a solution for some problem, let's say. And if you cannot identify these labels, you can also edit this over here. And the movement are validated, because B grade should not be more than A, so every validation is done. I should say it was not a difficult one. We completed it earlier, and we had the chance to test it in. We have unit tested it, we made documentation of it, and
you tested it, is it?
Unit tested it.
Okay, very fine. So I'll give you a problem. Okay, everybody has got 0 marks. Now do tell me how, let me see how it works.
Everybody got?
0 marks.
So I have to give?
You said you have enough time to test it properly, no? So I'm giving you a test condition.
So I should paste?
Everybody has got 0 marks. I want to see how your software works. You mentioned the word testing, I will give you hundreds of pathological tests.
No.
Okay.
We are not saying we tested every case.
No. You first tell me how this works.
Which
okay.
scheme should?
Whatever. No. Tell me how your software works.
Okay.
What boundaries you are going to draw. And show me that whatever your matrix.
We should follow some scheme now.
Follow any damn thing.
Okay.
I want to see what you do.
Okay. Let's say IITB. IITB default, as my professor said, he follows the minimum pass mark should be.
Kuch bhi karo yaar. Anything. I want to see the matrix.
So the minimum pass mark should be 0.4 into the A grade upper bound. So we have given all zeros. So it is here.
Correct. Yes. I had a choice to give all hundreds. Where are the boundaries?
These are the boundaries.
Boundaries
are present. So,
what boundary? No boundary in Indica.
We made
But move those bars, no?
Okay.
Here and there.
Where do I move? Huh? What should I move?
You are supposed to give me who has got F grade, who has got B grade according to your IIT guide.
I was giving here. You can see here the 15 people got zero fail grade.
All of them got fail grade, so their average GPA.
So the initial is zero and the new is zero.
I am looking at percentages. You are not showing me percentages. Lower bound is infinity something.
No, yes. Sir, because we are following a
zero
rather than following
a lower bound is infinity.
No, sir.
Minus infinity.
Zero,
instead of zero, we put minus.
Not zero, not every exam, if you have negative marks, because if you fix zero, it will be a discrete interval. So, everyone below 36 is a fail grade.
Now, I'll give you something. One person has got zero marks, one person got 100 marks, everybody has got 50. What boundaries are you going to put? You are not tested anyway, it doesn't matter. Go ahead. Don't talk to me about I have done testing. You can't. I am giving you one monolith. You can't do anything. I am giving you two monoliths. You can't do anything.
Just tell me the test case.
I told you one person has got zero. There are a lot of 50s and 100. What grading are you going to do?
I don't understand. What is your question?
My question is you allowing me to draw those lines.
Yeah.
Now draw those lines and publish the result.
Okay, we have still have the
correct. So what am I supposed to do? Why is it
no in this case
CD and CC?
Because we specified 90 as the A grade upper bound. IITB default this scheme follows.
Why is CC? It's right in the middle 50.
Yeah.
No, sir. That depends on the scheme.
And the scheme we select.
What scheme you selected? I don't understand your scheme. How it became CC is why I don't understand.
Oh, I'll explain. IITB default follows will give a A grade upper bound value. The minimum pass mark should be 40% of this value.
Yeah, so, all the 100 people will come and kill the professor if he does this.
That's why we can still drag these things. We can still make.
If it's not fair, you can drag it.
We have the custom option. We can even fix the grades. Let's say.
Anyway, it doesn't matter. You continue with your this thing.
Okay.
You will. Just you don't understand testing, you'll never understand testing. Go.
Technologies. So we used HTML, CSS and Chart.js library for implementing this thing. That's about it. And we also have additional functionalities like Zoom. And we also have two types of charts, both bar and line charts can be represented. That's about it. Thanks.
Okay.